there's a Maverick Games tonight, and I heard the men's are gonna be out, so we about to be out. So random. I do not have time because it's already on halftime right now. So I'm gonna quickly go. I'm not gonna take the camera with me. I'm gonna quickly go. I just wanted to hop on here and tell you guys what I'm gonna do. So your girl is going to go out and have some fun and get some mocktails.
People in therapy are often there to deal with people in their lives who won't go to therapy. I have a job, it's actually quite fulfilling, though my hairline is thinning. I barely do anything else. I read self-help books, I do meditation, walks in the woods, a new destination. Some days I wish I had a relationship status. Then I remember last time I ain't got time for that. I have a job, it's actually quite fulfilling, though my hairline is thinning. I barely do anything else. I read self-help books, I do meditation, walks in the woods, a new destination.
Mention that I did not go to the glow sauna due to the fact that it's booked, although the website shows multiple availabilities. It turns out that they're booked for the entire day, so I had to resort to come to LA Fitness and use their sauna because I had that set in my mind for today, and I'm just like, I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna find it a different alternative. Hi. Sorry. Okay, so it's literally late in the evening right now, and guess where I'm at? Yep, you guessed it. I'm at Ulta. So I have been waiting all day to see like what my friends are gonna do. So, okay, so let me just give you guys a backstory. Oh, this thing can't stay upright. Hold on.
I'll listen to this.
Okay. Alright, so quick backstory. This is not staying right. Okay, good. Yay! Okay, this should be good. Okay, yay! Alright, quick backstory. So, today, I technically, the only plan that was on my agenda. Oh my gosh. Okay guys, quick backstory before I was rudely interrupted by this camera falling on me. So, my sister and my friend were supposed to come over and watch Bridgerton. I thought we were going to have a whole night of Bridgerton, pretty much starting since 5, because it's 5 episodes and they're an hour long. But unfortunately, my friend can't come anymore because she's going through some things personally. And then my sister, she's pretty busy and she can't start watching until later tonight. So, my plans are ruined. And I am at Ulta Beauty right now in front of it. And I am going to grab me some Good Molecules products for my dark spots. There is this new product where it has vitamin C and this thing called Arizonol, I don't know how to say it correctly, but I will put it up here. It's called Arizonol, and it's together, and it's supposed to help with your black spots. So I'm gonna try that. Oh, you know what? I just realized that in the beginning of this video, I started it, and I was telling you guys I was going to go to this Mavericks game. Okay, so nothing crazy happened, but the day after, I was coming back from work and I was putting gas in my car, and I got stopped by this handsome man. Okay, so I've been telling this to everyone, and I need to know you guys' opinion. So I thought this man was handsome, and I still think he's handsome. He approached me. And very, very kindly and very, very gently. So points up for him for that. However, we got to talking later that evening, and I mean mostly everything checks out. But I don't know how to explain it. But he literally just started calling me sweetie out of nowhere, and I was like, I literally just met you like 3 hours ago, and it kind of, I don't know if it's because I'm not healed yet, but it kind of just triggered something in me, and it just made me feel like, why are you calling me sweetie? I just met you literally 3 hours ago. So yeah, so some of my friends that I've talked to about this, they have told me that I am exaggerating it, and I probably just don't like him as I thought I did initially. But for me, it's literally simply that he called me sweetie. I don't know. It kind of irked my soul. It irked my skin. Would you guys say though, that's love bombing? Cause that's how I feel like what it is. I feel like it's love bombing. Like it's straight up love bombing. It's too much. It's too much. Especially 3 hours. And I'm the type of person too, like if you hug me and I just met you, like why are we doing that? So
one thing I love doing when I come to Ulta Beauty is smelling all these perfumes. This smells so freaking good. Oh my god. Smells so good. This is the best. This smells so good. Oh my god. This is also some smells good too, but this is my favorite smell.
I love.
I said I came here for Good Molecules. I think we're trying to do La Roche-Posay. I've been hearing such good reviews about them. So I think I might try this for a month or two on my skin. So this, I think I'm definitely thinking about getting this. It's this Mila B3 serum, and it helps for dark spots and visible unifying dark spots. And also, I don't know if you can see it here, it says it helps with persistent dark spots on here. So I do have persistent dark spots, especially right after acne. And this has 10% niacinamide. Damn, it's not focusing. But as I was saying, it has 10% niacinamide, and I think I'm gonna compare it to the Good Molecules niacinamide and see if it has the same, if the percentage is the same, because this is a little expensive. But I think, actually, I don't know. But I'm definitely gonna leave with this purifying foaming cleanser. It's for oily skin, and I have oil skin. And then this astringent toner. So I wanna try those two. And then definitely this for my skin routine. And I'll try that for a month. And the reason is because the Korean skincare products that I bought, they're not really doing anything, and I've been using them. I actually haven't been using the vitamin C serums, which I probably should start using again, but definitely I wanna try this. Oh, I have the toner, so I'm gonna leave this toner behind. I'm gonna work on this. We'll see. Okay, so the niacinamide for the Good Molecules also has 10% niacinamide. And then the La Roche-Posay also has 10% as well. Should I go the less expensive route and just to get Good Molecules because it's less expensive, or should I try something new for my skin since it's really problematic? And these are still around the ballpark of Good Molecules prices. They're just like probably a bit like $2 more. So I think I'm definitely just going to try La Roche-Posay. If I don't like it, I can always just switch back or try something else. Cause I mean, I just gotta get rid of some of these things on my skin. Looks like someone's getting their car raided. Damn. And we are getting blocked. Okay. Yeah, this person's guy's getting their car raided. That sucks. All right, so I just got back home and I decided to make a little quick snack. So we have our salami here, cheese, some olives. This is goat cheese and some fig spread. A little bread that I just toasted. I got this from, these are samosas, veggie samosas. I got this from Whole Foods, and then I got me some falafels. That's also from Whole Foods, and then that's just hummus here. And then we have our sleepy girl little wine here. I'm gonna turn off the lights, but that's pretty much it. I'm just going to go watch this for tonight, call it a night. It's just gonna be me solo dolo. Per usual, it's always me solo dolo. So, yeah. Let's get this show on the road. I cannot wait to watch this because it's been so long and I just can't wait to see how it turns out.
It is said that surprise is one part secrecy and one part speed. And last night, an announcement came with great speed indeed.
We are engaged.